Good afternoon. Course title, Compiler Design, CS451, topic Syntax Analysis. We already discussed about the LR parsing. In the LR parsing, introduction to LR parsing properties and their structure, type of LR parser, simple LR parsing and the construction of the parsing table of SLR parsing, closure and go-to functions, they have covered, already covered. Now we will start the CLR, canonical LR parsing. See here, we have the context-free grammar. First is the first step is construction of the canonical set of items along with the A head. And second step is construction of canonical LR parsing table. Third is parsing of input string. We will select the string that belongs to this context-free grammar, and we will parse the string using the parsing table. So our first step is how can we construct the canonical set of items along with the look ahead. So this is the these are the steps to construct the set of items with a look ahead. First add a rule s test is dot s in the set of items. Then in the next step, for each set of items I will see and each gamma symbol x, maybe terminal or the non-terminal, add closure IIX. This process should be repeated by applying go to IIX, X for each x in II such that go to IIX is not empty and not in C. A set of items has to be constructed until no more set of items can be added. Then the closure function can be computed as for each item A is alpha dot x b beta a and the root x in gamma and b is the first of beta a such that x is this and b is not in the I and then add x is dot I to I. This algorithm is similar to the SLR, but here we have added one thing. Here we added this A, where this A block, where this A and the rule, we added this B and the B is the first of beta A. See the example. We have the grammar S is CC and C is AC and D. Consider the grammar. Construct LR1 set of items for the above grammar. According to the first step, first add the rules s test is dot s. So here also we will add a production rule s test is dot s. S is s. We will add this production. So now we will compute for this s dot s and this. Now compare this with the a is, compare with this a is alpha dot x beta a, x beta a, and here a equal to s dash, alpha is empty, x equal to s, beta is this, a is dot. Here x is s. According to this, see the rule, x is gamma. It means first step we have the production of this x. Here we have the production. So x is gamma comma b. So then add x, s is dot cc and this b, where this b belongs to first of beta k. B belongs to first of, so here beta is empty, a is dollar, so empty dollar, so b belongs to dot. So here this s is dot cc and this dollar added to i0. Next, same, s is dot cc dollar, compare with a is alpha dot x beta comma a, where a equal to s, alpha is null, x equal to c, beta is c, and a equal to dollar. Now compare this. Now see, do you have the root of this x? X is gamma b, then add c is dot ac and c is dot d. It belongs to b, where b belongs to first of beta a. It means b belongs to first of c dollar, first of c. So what is the first of c? C is here, first of c is a and b. The count is first of c is a c. So here c is dot ac dollar ac, a oblique d, and c is dot d, a. Finally, I0 is s is dot s dollar, c is dot c, s is dot cc dollar, c is dot ac, a or d, and d is c is d, a or d. This is I0. Then similarly the goto function can be computed for each item set. For each item A is this is in. So here now you can apply the goto statement. So goto I0 comma S. For this I0 comma S, so I1 is S dot, and this is the product. So this is I1. Next, computation of I1. Next is the computation of I2. Go to I0 comma C. I0 comma C for this S is C dot C and this one. Compare with A is now compare with A is alpha dot x beta comma a. A equal to s, alpha is c, x is c, beta is md, a equal to 1. See the rule, x is gamma dot b. Here for this C, we have the rule. So here we will add these rules. C is dot AC, C is dot D. Here D belongs to first of beta D. D belongs to first of empty and dollar. So this is D belongs to dollar. So for this AC we have this dollar. Now this I2 page, now we can write the I2 in this way. Go to I0 comma C. So that is I2 is C is S is C dot C dollar and C is dot AC dollar and C is dot G and this is dollar. So this is the I2. In this way, we can calculate I0, I1, I2, I3, I4 using the same algorithm. Finally, we have for this problem. In this way we can compute I0, I1, I2, I3, I4, I5, I6, I7 and I8 and I9. So next step is the construction of the parsing table. The construction of the parsing table is also same as the construction of the SLR table. All the rules are or similar. So here, see the step 1, initially construct set of items C equal to I0, I1, I2, up to IN. So the first step is compulsory to compute this. Second is, now see the action, parsing action, action and go to operations or statements and see how can we compute this. For the set I0, we have I0 is this, SS is dot S dollar, S is dot CC dollar, C is dot AC, A or D, and C is dot D, A or D. First C, this is I0. For this I0, now we want to see the shift or reduce operations. Here the rule is, first C, the production rule is C is dot AC, A or B. Compare with A is alpha dot A beta comma B. Again the same, after the dot, if you have the terminal, then we have the rules for the terminal. If we have the variables, then rule, we have the rules of the variable. If we have the variable, then we will use the rule number 3 and we will make the entry in the go-to columns. And if the terminals, then we will make the entry in the action column. In the action, again we have shift and reduce. So, see here, x is alpha dot a beta comma b is in ii, then go to ii, I 0 comma a means a equal to, see I0 comma a, I0 comma a, I0 comma a, so that is I3, so that is I3, so this is I3. Then create the entry in action I 0 comma a equal to shift 3 as 3. So in the table, so in the table 0 comma a, this is the S3. Like this, C is D. C is dot D. Again compare with A is alpha dot A beta B. Then go to I0 comma B. So I0 comma D is I0 comma D is I4. Action 0 comma D is S4. So in the table, for this D, 0 comma D, so that is the S4. Like this, see the entry for the variables. Here S is dot CC, this is dollar, and For this, here, this is the variable. After the dot, this is the variable. So apply the rule number 3. So here, in this case, go to I 0 comma C equal to I 0 comma C is I 0 comma C is I 2. And here for this another rule S is C is dot AC and A oblique D. So here go to I 0 comma A I 0 comma S is I 0 comma S is I 1. So make the entry according to the algorithm. Here go to II comma A is J. So here go to 0 comma C is 2. Here go to 0 comma S is 1. For the 0, 0 comma C, so that is 2. For 0 comma S, that is 1. In this way, we can make the entry in the parsing table. Next is now suppose we have this grammar S dash is S dot dollar S dot dollar, and what is the rule for this? Rule number this 2C. If there is a production, if S dash is S dot and dollar in II, then action, this rule is in 1. So action 1 comma dollar is equal to 0. So make the entry in the parsing table. 1 comma dollar, so that is a set. See the rules for the R3, R4 and R2. So first entry is in R3. Now the rule is I4, say the rule I4, C is D dot, and here this is A or D. According to the algorithm, now see the rule 2B. In the rule 2B, compare with A is alpha dot, and A is alpha dot comma A. Here A equal to C, alpha is D. In the action table, action I 4 comma A, 4 comma A is 4 comma A is Now the rules. Reduce by A is alpha, C is D. Here this is the rule 1, 2 and 3. So this is the rule number 3. R. So this is the rule for A and D. K equal to A or D. So this is the rule for action I4, D. So that is also equal to R3. So now in the table, I4 for the rule for the variable for the terminal A and D rule is R3. You can see in the rule number 5, for the rule 5, S is C, C dot dot. Again, compare with A is alpha dot and for this A. Here A equal to S, alpha is C and A equal to dot. Again, from the table, rule 2b, action I 5 comma dollar equal to, now the rules C, S equal to CC dot, S equal to CC, so that is R1. So here action is 5 comma dollar, action 5 comma dollar is R1. In the table, five comma dollar, so that is R1. In this way, we can construct the parsing table for every production rules. So this is the parsing table. We have the LR1 items. We have the set of LR1 items. So we can also construct the DFA like the SLR. I0, I1, I2, these shows or these represent the state of the DFA. As we build in the SLR. Like this. So I0, I1, I2, like this. For this I0, S, so that is I1, for C, that is I2, like this. Next is the parsing input using the LR1 parsing table. See, we have the parsing table. We have this parsing table. For this grammar, we can prepare or we can pass the input string. So select the string. Stack input buffer action table, go to table and the parsing action. Next is a We can now we can start from this is the stack. The stack is empty, so we can place the null, and we can take the string AADD dollar that belongs to this double. And here, see what action now we can take. Start from 0 and this A. So here the action 0 comma A. So that is equal to 0 comma A. Now from the table 0 comma A, 0 comma A, 0 comma A, so that is S3. So here this is the S3. This is the S3. Now this is the this perform shift operation. Shift. So we will shift the A in the stack. So 0 A 3. And here string is ADD dollar. Again, the next is 3 action 3 comma A. Now see what is 3 comma A. Again this is S3. It performs the shift operation. So this A again it will move in the stack A3, and here DD dollar. What is the next is again action 3 comma D. What is it? D, so that is S4. So again the operation is shift. And 0 A3 D4 is shifted in the stack. Here next is action 4 comma D. From this table 4 comma D, so that is the root R3. So here R3 is C is D, so this D is reduced by C is D. Next is use the rule for this. Now apply for this. Go to here. We will use C. So 3 comma C. So what is 3 comma C? From the table 3 comma C. So that is A. 3 comma C, so that is A. So here this is dollar 0 A3 here for this D C A. Next is D dollar action 8 comma D. So 8 comma D is 8 comma D. 8 comma D is R2. Again use the rule R2. R2 rule is C is AC. Reduced by C is AC. Here AC means this. Here 3 comma C. So what is 3 comma C? Again this is A. Again this is A. So now this dollar 0 A 3 C A. Then D dollar action 8 comma D, so that is R2. Same rule, reduce C is AC, this is AC, so 0 comma C. So what is 0 comma C? 0 comma C, so that is 2. So dollar 0 C 2. So that is D dollar action 2 comma D, 2 comma D, 2 comma D from the table. 2 comma D from the table, so that is the S7. S7 means 7. S7 means shift, so here shift the D 0 C to B7. Here the dollar next is action 7 comma dollar. So what is the entry in the 7 dollar? So 7 comma dollar, for this dollar the rule is R3. So R3 means C is reduce C is D. C is D, so replace this D by the C. This is dollar 0 C to C, and here 2 comma C equal to 5. 2 comma C, so that is equal to 5. Here C 5. So that is dollar action 5 comma dollar is five comma dollar, so that is equal to R1. The rule R1 is S is CC, reduce S is CC. So here this is CC, so that is replaced by S. Here 0 comma S is zero comma S is 1. So this is 1. Next is dollar 0 S 1. This is dollar and action is 1 comma dollar, so that is equal to asset. 1 comma dollar is asset. 1 comma dollar is equal to asset. So we can say that string it belongs to this grammar is accepted by this part. This. So in this way we can construct the CLR, and we can pass the, and we can construct a canonical set of items, or we can say LR1 items and we can construct a parsing table from the LR1 sets, and then we can take the string that if the string it belongs to this grammar, then using the parsing method string is accepted. If the string is not belongs to this grammar, then it will generate the errors. So in the next class we will discuss about the LALR. Thanks.